Right, we're ready to go. This plaster cloth stuff is very, very messy. So it's best to cover as much of the area that you're working around with either newspaper or plastic sheet or something like that. The dust off the plastic cloth goes everywhere, but also whenever you get it wet, it starts to drip everywhere too. And if you have areas that are already produced, there's scenics on it, you don't want to be dolloping big bits of wet plaster all over it. So cover your area as much as you can. The only things that you need are a roll of plaster bandage. Now you pick these up, I think the pack of three that I bought was only what, £3.50 or something like that, so they're not expensive. And what I've done already is cut some of them into shorter strips and varied the length of these strips for what I'm going to do. The area we're going to cover is this here, and what I want to do is make sort of a natural hill here and around here, sloping down to the road and back down to the car park. So there, a slight mound is what we're looking for here, and we'll blend it in onto the road. So we'll get our plaster bandage, prepare it. We have a container of water, and I have a tea towel or a cloth as well, just for wiping hands, because it can get a wee bit messy, and if you're moving, changing stuff and that, it's useful to have an old rag of some description around as well. The only other thing then we're going to use is some newspaper. Now the newspaper I'm going to use to create that initial relief in this area, and then the plaster bandage will be laid over the top of it. It just helps to give it some support. In this area here and some of the other areas, I'm using the card dividers to help create the contours, but for something that's so small as this, I don't think that's really necessary. I'd actually started earlier in doing that, but decided to scrap the idea, thinking, you know, some scrumbled up newspaper would be enough just to work in this area. Like I say, it's literally just there to give the plaster some support until it dries, because once it dries hard, well, it's not going to move anyway. So we'll take some newspaper, and this will probably get a bit noisy on the camera here. And I try and scrumple it and fold it in underneath on itself so it doesn't all spring back up, and it also gives you that chance to mould it slightly. So if I put that just in there, that's not bad actually. You're already getting an idea of what we're looking to do. So I'll work the way around here the rest of it. Now with that corner, I need to manipulate the newspaper a little bit to help get it around it. Again, I'm not concerned about overlapping into the road. In actual fact, I want that to a certain degree, because it'll take the sharp edge off the edges of the road, and particularly at this sharp corner in the car parking area. And once the scatter goes down, that'll blend a wee bit more, and it'll soften these edges even more so. You know, this is a countryside station, so it's not maybe going to have that regimental look that you would have in the city centre. Once again, I'm not looking for uniformity here either. I want a slight undulation. I don't want everything sitting at the same height. And as it comes down to the track with a slope here, we need to slope it down, that this is all going to meet here anyway. So this should probably be the last piece of paper we need. use the road a little bit there. There's a slight lip on that, so I can tuck in underneath that to help hold that in place. Now this will all soften down, or it springs up a little bit, but as you lay the plaster cloth on, it will start to, you know, keep to its position. So that's all right, I think. Yeah, right, that's in. So the next stage is we take a plaster bandage and I'm going to dip it in a container of water. It only needs to go in for a few seconds. Lift it back out again, and already you can see the plaster starting to blend, and we'll lay that into position. You don't need to be too neat. You're going to be overlaying with others on top of that, but I like to get around the edges to get that meeting point between the landscape scenics and the hard surface of the road beneath. Again, by applying a bit of pressure as you're putting the bandage on, will also change the contours of that newspaper that's underneath, and will just help give it a much more natural look. As the plaster hardens, you'll be able to start manipulating it a little bit more, and it'll stay in position a lot easier too. You see the way this is all overlapping onto the card. If I was to do this after I had treated the entire card, well, one, we've got plaster spots all over it, so it's going to destroy any work that you've done on the road surface. But also, the idea is to use some tile grout, and it's going to smear a whole layer right across all the card. It'll fill in the joins, and it'll overlap onto this, and it'll make everything a more of a seamless surface. And then once that the scenic scatter is all added into it, you can soften up those lines again between the grass verge and the road.
Thank you.
we're getting very close to point work there. I don't want any water dripping down through the hole, so best to mop that up. Right, that is more or less it, I think. I'm really just layering up on top now just to build up the strength of the hill now. Now as I've been working on this, working sort of from right to left, those areas on the left hand side are now really beginning to firm up. It's not 100% solid yet, but it is a lot firmer. But what it does let you do at this stage is sort of to manipulate, you know, we can move that around a wee bit, soften the slopes on it, blend it in a wee bit more. There's a little bit of a dip there between the two pieces of paper. Perhaps that looks okay, and of course when static grass and that goes onto it, you're probably not going to notice that. One wee gap in there that dips down, does that look alright? I'm not sure. This here sits up quite a bit, but I think that's okay. It looks quite natural to me. So there you are. Very straightforward process. You can see how just by using the newspaper and then also the plaster on top, that you're getting quite a natural sort of look to the landscape around it. It softened all these edges around the car park. Actually, I'm going to fill in that gap, I don't like it. It softened around those edges, the same again on the roadside. And once it's all painted and the tarmac sections are all done, I think it'll look not too bad. And it's quite steep hills if you put cars, you know, if I put, let me just fill that in first. That's better. I take a car. Yeah, doesn't sit too bad. It's quite high in places, but I think that's okay. Down here, you know, this whole area to me is the roads, the railway, everything has been cut into the actual landscape. So these high sloping hills and that to me look okay. And actually, if you drive down, you know, through the countryside yourself, you'll find that there are high embankments on either sides of the roads, with the fields maybe sitting higher up in that, you know, from so yeah, quite happy. There's a wee gap here, but we'll sort that out with the tile grout whenever it comes to layering this. These wee areas can be blended in, the same with the gaps here against the abutments of the bridge will all be blended in with the tile grout. But anyway, I think that's enough waffling on that. I hope this is of use to you. I hope the whole video with regards to this whole section is of use or of help to anybody. Please feel free to comment, like the video, and if you haven't already subscribed, click the subscribe button too so you can follow further progress. So until the next time, thanks for watching and I'll chat soon. Bye.